Hi, I'm Greg McMillan. Thanks for visiting McMillanRunning.com. In today's video, we're going to talk to you about a type of workout that you may have never heard of, a neuromuscular workout. Us distance runners tend to run a lot of long, slow miles, and that's okay. We need to do that. But it will help us immensely, though, if we do them as efficiently as possible. That's where neuromuscular workouts come in. They are very different than pretty much every other kind of workout distance runners do. And here's the good news. They're really short, and they really help you run fast. They do ask a lot of your body, though, namely of the brain and the muscular system, and their ability to work together. When we run fast, we are asking our fast twitch muscle fibers to fire at a rapid rate. For sprinters, this comes very naturally. For distance runners, not so much. But we can get better at it, and if we do it right, it can lead to faster times, even at longer distances. A classic neuromuscular workout is to run 8 to 10 repeats of just 20 seconds each, but at a pace very near maximum effort. So think mile race pace, or even a little faster. Here you'll see McMillan Running's assistant coach and resident Olympian Andrew Limoncello doing a neuromuscular workout here in Flagstaff. He's running fast, but not all out, working to maintain good running mechanics and turning his legs over very, very quickly. He then jogs very slowly before beginning the next stride. In fact, most runners and coaches call neuromuscular workouts stride workouts since they work to help improve your stride. Watch Lemon as he runs these fast repeats. He's running with absolutely perfect form, head and shoulders relaxed, leaning ever so slightly forward, feet getting up and down off the ground very quickly. We typically look better at this pace than we do when we're jogging, but the idea is that if we practice this enough, it will begin to carry over to our longer workouts as well. After all, the less time we spend on the ground, the faster we will go. Preface these workouts with a good warm-up and finish with a good cool-down, since these efforts, while short, will likely be new to you. I recommend you do these workouts once every week or two, year round. Take about 1 minute jog recovery between each 20 second burst, and be very careful when you try these for the first time. Err on the side of caution with your speed. These can be a shock to the system, so don't force them. Just run nice and smooth, and the speed will come. Enjoy.